Hello. Last week, I have done a session on the Festive Tech Calendar 2022 on how to get started with Microsoft Azure and the Azure Container Apps. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a RabbitMQ cluster on Microsoft Azure in less than 10 minutes. So during the demo, which I talked about last week, I had to create a RabbitMQ on Microsoft Azure, and I briefly talked about how to get it done by going through this repository. Instead of going through the repository, I'm going to show you live how we can get started with creating a RabbitMQ cluster using Azure Portal. So let's head over to the Azure Portal and let's create a resource group to start with. Now I'm going to use some of the prerequisites so that it becomes easier, and I'm going to reuse some of the resources used for that demo. So I want to create a resource group here. And I can search for resource group, and in the list, let's click on create a resource group. Resource group is a concept in Microsoft Azure, which is used to create related resources. It's a logical container where we can put all our resources together. So I'm going to create this in Southeast Asia, Asia Pacific, and I have Southeast Asia data center here or region, and the name that I want to give is Azure Container Apps RG for the resource group. Let's review and create this. So the validation passes and let's create the resource group. Now this resource group is created immediately, and we can head over to the resource group and then we can create the RabbitMQ cluster. Now I'm going to use Bitnami, which is one of the provider of open source software, which provides packages which can be used on the public cloud as well as on the private cloud. It makes it easier for us to package the commonly used open source software. And Bitnami has a package for RabbitMQ. There is no default managed offering by Microsoft Azure at this point in time for RabbitMQ, which is one of the most popular messaging platforms. So I'm going to use Bitnami for this. So let's go and search for the RabbitMQ here. In the Azure Marketplace, we can search for RabbitMQ by Bitnami. That should quickly bring us to the page or the section which we can use to create the RabbitMQ cluster. So in here, under the resource group, let's go and create a new resource. Again, we are going to search in the marketplace, and in the search criteria, we put RabbitMQ by Bitnami for quick search. We will get multiple options. So we have the virtual machine, we have a container apps, we have the container itself. So if you are using, let's say, the AKS or Azure Kubernetes service, we can use these Helm charts or the container apps provided by Bitnami. Right now we are going to use a virtual machine, and we select this create the RabbitMQ cluster option under the virtual machine section. It's going to ask us some questions. So we are going to give specific names for the VM. So I'm going to name that VM as RabbitMQ. So here we can see that when we click on the create virtual machine in the marketplace for RabbitMQ, it's going to assign it to the default subscription or whatever subscription I'm currently in, and the resource group as Azure Container Apps RG, because that is where we selected the create resource option. In the VM name, I'm going to give it as RabbitMQ, and the region, again, I want to select as the Southeast Asia in Asia Pacific. I don't want availability option at this point in time. I'm going to use a single instance, no redundancy for this demo. And the security type is also standard. The image that we are going to use is RabbitMQ package by Bitnami 64 gen. There are other versions of these images. So if you are running a Linux machine, or if you want the Linux image to be used, like the Ubuntu server 20.04 LTS image, we can select, or we can use other versions of the supported images. I'm going to use the default image here, and I'm going to leave all the defaults as is. I don't want to change anything at this point in time. When it comes to the authentication for creating the administrator account, we can choose SSH public key or password. I'm going to use the password based approach here, and I'm going to specify a password. You can give your own password. So I'm going to put, first we need to give a user before we get to the password. So let's create a user as admin. Okay, now the patch. So then we can go ahead and select the disk and other characteristics, but again I'm going to stick to the defaults and I'm going to review and create. If everything is fine, if all the defaults are okay in the review, I would be getting the option to create this particular VM, which will have the RabbitMQ cluster installed on that, or RabbitMQ software installed on that. So looks like there is some validation which has failed. Let's go and check. Okay, so admin is a reserved keyword. So let's say RabbitMQ admin as the user, review and create. So this will give us the cost estimate, which is like 0.0132 USD per hour. I'm okay with this. I'm going to create the VM with RabbitMQ on this now. So using this marketplace image for RabbitMQ by Bitnami, we are creating a RabbitMQ cluster or RabbitMQ VM on the resource group which we created. And within a short period of time, we will see that it creates various other resources, dependent resources which are required for this VM. Like it will create the network security group, it will create the public IP using which we can connect to the RabbitMQ, and it will also create the actual virtual machine, and it will have the RabbitMQ installed on that. So this is one way of creating a RabbitMQ on Microsoft Azure, and I found this one of the quickest way of doing. In the subsequent video or in a later video, I'll also show you how to do the same thing using the Azure CLI, which is much more faster compared to going through all these options on the Azure portal. But for now, let's go through the portal and see what we need to do in order to connect to this VM. Now deployment has succeeded and we can go to the resource and we can connect to this RabbitMQ VM. In order to connect, we can go and hit this connect option, and I'm going to use SSH to connect. So when we select the SSH option, it will tell us that we need this, we can use this example using SSH, and we can provide the private key path, and then user is the RabbitMQ admin and the public IP of this particular RabbitMQ VM. So I just need this because I have specified the password instead of giving the SSH key. So I'm going to say SSH, and then it is the RabbitMQ admin as the user and the VM name or the public IP of the VM. So it will ask me if I want to add this to the known host. I will say yes, and then it will ask me for the password. So I will give whatever is the password that I specified at the time of creating the VM. And here we can see that we are now logged into the VM. We can see what is the default password. So it tells us that it is packaged by Bitnami 3.1.11.5 and -3 version, this particular VM. It's accessible on this public IP 4.193.173.87, and then it also gives us links to the documentation and how to use other things related to the RabbitMQ cluster. Now, if we want to use this RabbitMQ via the application to produce, let's say, messages or to create queues and also to consume that, we need to expose the 5672 port so that the application or we can connect from outside to this VM. In order to do that, we need to run certain commands, and I'm going to use Azure CLI commands for that to open the port. So the first port that I'm going to open is 5672. So I'll use the open port command here, AZVM open port. The port number is 5672. Name of the VM is RabbitMQ and the resource group is Azure Container App RG that we created. So once this tab opens up, I'm going to paste that particular command in the tab. I'm using the Windows terminal here, which allows me to have the tabbed interface in my terminal. If you have not used Windows terminal, I highly recommend that you can have a look at it. It's quite customizable and you can see that I have all these things showing on my terminal. You can do all this fancy stuff with Windows terminal. So here we are running this command to open the port 5672. While this command is getting executed, I will also open the port for the management UI, which is used to connect to the RabbitMQ's management capabilities. So by default, this is exposed on 15672 port. So I'm going to open that port as well for this VM. So we run the same open port command, but this time we will be using 15672 as the port number, and we also give a priority as 1100. Rest of the things remains the same in terms of the name of the RabbitMQ VM and also the resource group. So once the 5672 port and 15672 management port is open, we can then communicate with this VM or RabbitMQ instance on Azure. So let me open the browser and let's try to connect to this particular port 15672. So I'm going to use this same IP and let's give the port number 15672. Here we need to provide the username and password to connect to the management UI, and there is a default user called user created by the Bitnami. This is a default user for all the RabbitMQ instances. In order to find what is the password or the default password, we can use that SSH command, or we can log into that VM and look at the credentials of this file. These are stored in a file called bitnami underscore credentials. So we are going to read the contents of that file and retrieve the password. So I'll switch the tab here again. We are connected to the RabbitMQ VM and I'm going to use the cat command here. So in this file, you can see that there is a default username, which is named as user, and the password is whatever is the password shown here. So let me copy this password and we head over to the browser and we put this as the password. Then when we click login, we are presented with the RabbitMQ management UI, using which we can look at the overview, the connection channel, exchanges, queues, and the admin capabilities. So this is how we can quickly create a RabbitMQ instance on Microsoft Azure. If you want to know how to interact with this, you can have a look at the video which I created last week about Azure Container Apps and how it uses Dapper to connect to RabbitMQ, and it populates the messages or it ingests messages onto the RabbitMQ using a producer and how to consume those messages. Thank you for watching this video. Until next time, code with passion and strive for excellence.